before I had my first fight, I never wanted to do it again. I never wanted to be in that place again. Because I've never felt like that before. But now it's just natural. It feels natural when I'm in there.
For the tournament, we haven't ever given out a championship belt. We've never, over the last 10 or 11 years we've been doing this, we always found it kind of odd that everybody had a world champion. And to me, that diluted the meaning of being a world champion.
The winner of the fight, and first ever CWC lightweight champion!
We want to make it credible by making it a tournament format, which is very, very tough on the fighters, but I think they should be afforded the respect of a champion, whether it's a world champion or a UK champion. You know, I think we've picked, you know, guys who really have a great desire to, you know, to win this. Tommy Maguire, he is a tough fighter. He's got good stand-up, good wrestling, and a good, you know, a good ground game.
Well, if the crowd ain't on my side, you know, it doesn't really matter because they can't help him. You know, I think it'd be real good for my career to win the contract, because it's, you know, just moving on to bigger, better things.
Bobby McVittie, Scotland, very, very fit, very aggressive.
I'm going in there to prove a point, so the more of a point I've got to prove, the better, really.
Ali MaClean, tough wrestler, big heart, very hungry kid, really wants this.
Doesn't make a difference to me who I get. They're all going to lose, like, so.
Nomaan Khalid, I'm expecting him to be quite explosive. You know, he's got something to offer.
Oh, if I was to win a tournament, it would be another level knowing that you're good enough to take on these fighters.
The winner will get a three-fight contract, and that'll be a rolling contract. It will continue as long as they continue to win. In our opinion, it's very, very evenly matched, and, you know, we've been discussing, you know, who do we think is going to come out on top. And to be honest, we've drawn a blank on it, because I think the guys all cancel each other out in different matchups. It's definitely a well-balanced tournament, and I think, you know, we're going to see some really great fights there.
I'm Ali MaClean, and I fight out of Chumsut. I'm a full-time professional MMA fighter. I always enjoy wrestling, I always enjoy hard pads, but I hate cardio, like, and high-paced plyometrics and circuits and stuff. It's just hard to push it. You have to push yourself hard, like, and it's hell. You're happy afterwards, but when you're doing it, you're just knackered.
Out of all the people I've met over the years who want to be a champion, I don't think I've ever met anybody that is this hungry for it, someone who's actually given up everything in their life.
Outside of the gym, the only thing I really do is spend time with my girlfriend.
Oh no, it keeps going left! It's just bad.
I do wrestling. It's dead handy, I can train with him and stuff, and then he knows where I'm coming from whenever I'm training. But I wouldn't say it's just like going out with MMA fighter, it's just like going out with Ali.
It would be hard if Jenny wasn't so understanding, but because she's so understanding, that we work really well.
For the training, I do kind of pick up wee niggly injuries, and going to the oxygen tank helps improve the recovery time of them.
Okay, Ali, bringing you up now, okay?
It gets cold, your ears pop, so as if you're flying off in a plane, you know, it's the same sort of feeling. And then when you're coming back down, there's like a big fog comes and it's your ears pop again.
That's 10 you've done, 10 dives.
It's not too bad, you know, it's fine. Like it's, you can see the benefits bust straight away.
Ali would come here because he knows it feels good. It's like a confidence booster to him. He said, nothing wrong with that. Because it does, it's like having an extra tank of petrol in your car.
When I go into training, I feel I can go longer, I can go through harder training sessions. On top of that, any time I went in the oxygen tank, I've never lost. I've only lost times I haven't went into it, so for me, it's sort of like a confidence booster.
As far as my fighting style goes, I can grind out fights or can finish them quite quickly. I've done both in the past, so it works quite well. Whatever needs to be done to win the fights, I'll do, you know. The payoff for me is getting the belt and elbowing someone in the face. I would like to see it as a chess match, but to be honest, most of the time I just go in there to hurt someone, so not intensely, but you know, in order to win the fight.
Ali MaClean, AKA Insane MaClean!
Having a home crowd, there's a lot of pressure. You know, obviously, when the bells, most of the crowd want to see me winning it, like, it'll be good to hear the Belfast crowd cheering me on and giving me support, you know, hopefully help me to win.
If I win this tournament, you know, I get a contract from Cage Wars with it, you know, they treat me well, and they're getting bigger and bigger and bigger each year. To be honest, I don't mind who I get. I mean, one's named after a biscuit, one's ginger and fat, and the other one's called Nomaan. Doesn't make a difference to me who I get. They're all gonna lose, like, so.
My name's Bobby McVittie. I fight out of Team Viper, Port Glasgow.
Bobby McVittie, very, very fit, very aggressive, much like McLean. So I would see his attributes as stamina and drive. And again, another guy who's very hungry for this.
He's got the whole right attitude and just want to do better and get there all the time. And he's just aiming high every time. That's what you really need to do if you're actually going to get anywhere. And I think he's got the ability to do that.
I'm taking E.
It's that belt, it's that drive, and I think, you know, that fits Bobby. He's very skillful, powerful young man, and definitely driven as well to get this.
At the age of 5, I started training in judo. I then joined Bogle Stone Judo Club, and one of my coaches there, Chris, he then went on to teach mixed martial arts, and I just sort of followed on when I was 16, 17. My family's quite supportive. A little bit sort of worried when I'm in there, but I think that's just natural. My girlfriend, Jane, she's really supportive. She goes to all my fights, so yeah, I've got back in there.
Well, I like going to the fights. It's a great experience and stuff, you know, it's a great atmosphere and things, but it's like, I've been right up with them through the training and everything else. It's almost as if I'm in there as well, and I'll be screaming like a banshee, as you probably will see. And like, it's like high adrenaline the whole way, and then after the fights, it's like, and then it's as if I have a right come down. It's like you lose the adrenaline and stuff, but it's amazing a feeling like when he's won and he's happy and whatever. But same time again, it's still amazing even if he goes in and he loses, because he's went in and take part and he's done his best.
My job title just now is senior fitness advisor. I work in the Kilmacombe based gym here, Buckman Park, within and Clyde Leisure.
And while we're up here, a few more clicks, and we're going to go flat out. Off we go.
My job factors in really well, for the reason being the company's comes and goes with me really well. If I've got a fight coming up, I'll get time off. My shifts are set shifts, so I can work training around about that as well. In terms of preparation for fight, then it's no different from any other fight. Treat all my fights the same, train hard, hope to train hard and fight easy, really. And obviously, with working in a gym, then I can do a lot of my fitness work, strength and conditioning work, before work or straight after work, yeah.
Level 4 on the legs.
My style's quite aggressive. I like to go in there and basically beat up my opponent as quick as possible. In terms of fighting, I prefer to be in there brawl and sprawl as such, but I'm really comfortable on the ground. I've won quite a lot of my fights on the ground, but I do prefer to stand and bang, yeah. I'm going in there to prove a point, so the more of a point I've got to prove, the better, really. Basically, the strategy would be to finish the first fight as quick as possible, stay fresh and injury-free, really, and just then knuckle in and prepare for the next one. And there's a free fight deal for Cage Wars, which basically that's what I'm looking for, the sort of deal on the big promotion.
My name's Nomaan Khalid. I'm a welder, I'm an exhauster. I'm 26 years old, fighting out of Team Ronin on the way.
Nomaan Khalid is out of a great gym. He's out of Andy Jardine's gym. And, you know, so he's got a great instructor there and a guy who was a great fighter.
Okay. It doesn't matter, he's kicking you here. Catch, bang, come round, okay?
Nomaan's going to be a good striker, without a doubt. I'll be pretty sure that when, you know, when he's coming out of Andy Jardine's gym, that this kid's, you know, he's got something to offer.
I was mainly into boxing. I used to do a lot of stand-up fighting. And then I found myself quite restricted when I'd be getting too many shots. I'd want to take someone down, kick them or something like that. When I saw MMA, it was like, you know, that opening. It was something that I wanted to do. The sport is like an art. It's being able to control somebody to stop them in the tracks. You know, like you could choke them out. Striking. It's a passion, it's just a good sport. Don't mind standing up. If he wants to take it to the floor, I'm happy there. That's just what I'm working on. I'm working on the stand-up and the groundwork, wrestling. I'm happy to fight anywhere, really. And that's what it is with MMA. I mean, I'm good at stand-up fighting, but I wouldn't go for boxing. It's a whole different game. You've got to just be there, you know? With MMA, you've got to work up and down. You know, I would never put boxers down. Boxing is where I started. Boxing is what I do. That's my background. But when I saw jiu-jitsu and wrestling, you know, kickboxing, it just puts it all into place. You know, it makes the sport. Sometimes I go in there and just start exploding. And before you know it, you're gassed out. So it's just about pacing yourself and making sure that you're okay for the next fight. Well, my parents, they don't accept it. It's because obviously they don't want their son getting hurt. That's understandable, so I understand where they're coming from. My wife, you know, she says, you train too much, you're always in the gym, you always train, so I could understand that. It's just about compromising, you know, just trying to balance out your life with training, which is difficult, but it could be done.
Good.
Overall, everyone's supportive.
One, two.
But they've got that worry that, you know, I don't want him getting hurt, but that's family. I like being the underdog. I don't mind going anywhere to fight. It doesn't threaten me, it doesn't make a difference. When I'm in the ring or in the cage, I'm there to do a job, I'm there to fight. So it doesn't matter my surroundings, where I am, you know, I'm just going to get in there and fight. I'd like to take fighting as far as I can. I don't want to get to that stage where I only stop because of injury or anything like that. I want to keep it going till I can. But if I was to win a tournament, it'll be another level and it'll be a confident boost, knowing that you're good enough to take on these fighters and move on to the next level.
I'm Tommy Maguire. I fight at Tsunami Gym. Crown Fight Centre in Cambridge. Just started watching UFC, probably like a lot of guys, and then just found a place to train and just started training it. Never had no intentions of fighting, but you know, just fell into it, really. My brother fights also, and seeing him do real well, you know, it just motivates me to try and get better. You met me from my brother at the gym, and I got like a stepbrother as well, and we all fight. Yeah, but no, we just really fell into fighting, really, because none of our families were ever fighters or anything, but we just fell into it. Actually, no, before I had my first fight, I never wanted to do it again. I'd never wanted to be in that place again, because I'd never felt like that before. But now it's just natural. It feels natural when I'm in there. I'm a full-time fighter, full-time MMA fighter. I like both, you know, the technical aspect and also the aggression, you know. I think it complements each other. You know, I can be real technical, but I can also be just trying to punch you in the face, you know. If someone gets you in a technical move, the way to get out of that technical move is just hit them. And that usually gets you out of the situation. The sacrifice of just training, just having no life, it's more than a 9-to-5 job. You know, everything's about fighting. Here's all me friends. Something else? Hey? I got a big fight coming up in Ireland. Sort of doing all filming and that.
Are you fighting?
I got possibly two fights in one night. Just Irish chores and Scottish one, I think.
Good fight, Tommy.
Yeah.
Good luck, man.
I come from an Irish background as well, so fighting in a big arena, especially in Ireland as well. First time fighting like abroad, so it'd be good. Well, if the crowd ain't on my side, you know, it doesn't really matter because they can't help him. So hopefully I have a few fans over there. Yeah, well, I just go with my game plan. You know, I try and dictate the pace of the fight. If I want to keep it standing, I try and keep it standing. But if I feel like they're getting the better, I'm going to stand up after I take them down. But I try to dictate the pace all the time. You know, I think it'd be real good for my career to win the contract, because, you know, just moving on to bigger, better things. But hopefully I can win it.
Tonight, four promising young fighters face the fight of their lives as they compete against each other to be crowned the first ever Cage Wars champion. Whoever lifts that lightweight title belt will win the much coveted three-fight contract. So who has the endurance, the heart, the skill worthy of a champion?
Just your last thoughts as you head out into the ring?
All right, everybody, welcome. This is the first fight of our lightweight tournament this evening. The winner of the tournament will be crowned the CWC Lightweight Champion of the World. Ali MaClean in the black trunks. Tommy Maguire in the long black board shorts. Here we go, round one underway.
Maguire showing some respect. That's what I love about our sport. You know, he came in, wanted to touch the hands. Good, clean competition, Jay.
And Tommy Maguire, a true sportsman, fighting out of Wisbech, Tsunami Gym, under Robbie Oliver. He's 9-3 as a pro.
Very composed, both of them, both taking their time, both measuring the game right now.
155 pounds for our fans in the States watching us. Both these guys big, especially MaClean, look big for 55.
Maguire showing a lot of skill, just barely moving out of the way, the kicks, a good feints, knows to slip accurately, very good stand-up by Maguire.
Insane Ali MaClean, the 2009 Irish Freestyle Wrestling Champion. Oh, good hands there by MaClean.
He's a little fire plug, MaClean. When they're pushed, going for the single, really putting a lot of pressure now.
Gets the single.
defense there by Maguire, reaching around.
Going for the guillotine.
The guillotine.
Didn't get a good strong grip in it, but he's still very composed on the ground, Maguire. He's controlling the elbows.
Tommy Maguire, the anger management world title holder.
Yeah, McLean has a chance to really explode now. You know, he's got a good chance. This would be it. He should explode a bit more here. Going for the guillotine, though.
Very early, tight. He's going for it. You want to finish off your opponent early when you have a tournament format. And that is exactly what it looks like insane Ali MaClean is looking to do right now. Trying to soak in the guillotine.
A nice pop-up reverse by Maguire, though. He takes his head out and puts it right back under McLean's elbow.
And now McLean standing up, looking to straighten out. He's got a tight choke now. It's starting to sink in.
That's very tight there, Jay.
What's the defense for Maguire?
You know, he needs to grab onto the elbow, grab onto the wrist, and overhook the top part of McLean's shoulder to escape that. I don't see him grabbing much by what I can see from here, but he sits back out. He's got a slight angle, so he might be able to pop his head out, and I think he will.
Boy, he's tough. Boy, Maguire's tough. He withstands the choke attempt from McLean.
A lot of true grit there.
Going for the arm now is Maguire.
Almost got a homoplata there. You know, McLean showing very good posture right now too as well. I think you hit the nail on the head earlier, Jay. You want to finish your fight early. You don't want to go the full distance here.
Maguire, a fighter who fights with his heart. He says, everything that I have comes from within.
You know, McLean's actually having a hard time finding a clean shot. Maguire very good at nullifying, even though he's in a bad position. He's able to nullify McLean. McLean can't really get a good shot on him, which I'm sure that what he wants to do right now. He's going for a modified dast there, looks like, almost.
Trying to let that left hand go. And in response, Maguire looking to get those legs up, perhaps an up kick, but he couldn't position them the way he wanted to.
Yeah, Maguire is very defensive on his back. He has good defense, knows how to nullify shots very good.
Maguire is a wrestler as well. Boxer on his feet, wrestling on the ground. That's an American pedigree. I wonder if he spent any time in the States.
Got that Kimura locked, actually, Maguire, McLean. He's looking to pop that out. He's got the elbow popped in. He just needs to pop it out of the body right now. Let's it go.
But right now, McLean's corner calling for him to let the elbows go.
Going for the guillotine again. He likes that guillotine. You know, Maguire puts his neck out there, and that's why he gets caught in that position over and over again.
You serve that neck up enough times, and you're going to get caught.
Yeah, he almost gives it to him a little bit.
10 seconds to go in the opener. There go the lefts from McLean. A good round from McLean.
Yeah, he's definitely winning this round, but he doesn't get enough leverage in his shot. That's all more power to Maguire. He's able to nullify a lot of the action in the bottom there.
Maguire, with a lot of cage experience, has 12 pro fights. As we take a look at the action from the opener.
You know, McLean pushing in, goes for the single. You know, was able to pressurize Maguire, put him in his back, go for the numerous guillotine attempts. Couldn't finish him off. You know, Maguire showing a lot of savvy, Jay. You know, you can see that pro experience coming through there.
This one has two more five-minute rounds at least scheduled. Both of these combatants looking to end this early and go into their second tournament fight with a well-rested body.
If I was Tommy, I would up the ante in the striking. You know, he seems to have maybe a slight edge in the striking. He needs to really pressurize. Lands a beautiful inside kick into McLean.
To the inner left thigh and calf of McLean. And a McLean answers with a nice kick to the chest of Maguire.
Beautiful counter there by McLean. Nice body shot by Maguire. He's trying to mix it up a little bit. He has excellent range, actually, Maguire. He just needs to, you know, get a cleaner counter going on there.
Almost taking McLean's back.
Putting a lot of pressure. Oh, wow, he got McLean on his back. He dipped under those punches, took him down. A nice double. Let's see how McLean works that guard now, you know. You know, Jay, both these guys are really experienced. It's really hard to get a clean shot on either of these guys because they're both there to nullify, put the posture down, grab the head, grab the wrist. Really hard to get a clean shot.
It's that classic situation of fighting a fighter that makes you look bad. Taking the back now is Maguire.
Gets one hook in, needs to get the other now. McLean's got to be a little careful here, you know.
What's the defense for McLean?
McLean needs to spin out, push that leg out, spin out, try to go over, and if he can't get out, try to give him the mount and switch out. McLean needs to switch out. It's going to be very hard now because Maguire's got both hooks in there. It's serious trouble for McLean. Maguire might get this choke here, Jay. It's looking pretty dangerous.
Oh, it's tight now.
He
tight.
Needs it.
No, he's got his chin tucked in. He's okay, but there's a cut. It looks like maybe over the right brow of McLean's eye.
Needs to release one hook and spin out, Jay. One hook. McLean needs to release one of those hooks. Or try to do a real quick spin, you know. But he's in a little bit of trouble here. And, you know, while in this position too, Maguire is able to pepper him those short, crisp shots. You know, try to get his chin up, pull the head up.
Difficult to see where that blood is coming from. There was some blood on the top of McLean's head, but that might have just brushed up from Maguire.
Bingo, he spun out. He spun out. I don't know how much minutes left on the clock, but I think McLean is losing this round. Needs to put the pressure now. He's got Maguire back in the. He's got Maguire in his back and needs to put the pressure.
Let those elbows go. And to answer your question, he has plenty of time left. He's got over a minute and a half to try to put some offense together and steal this round.
He needs to be a bit more busy, McLean. Needs to work that body. Tommy's still active in his guard. You know, went for the armbar there. Unfortunately, there was too much space and distance between the head.
Letting those elbows go. With a minute and a half to go here in the second round. This is the first fight of a lightweight tournament. Ali MaClean on top.
He's getting a bit more cleaner shots now. He's getting a bit more. He's figuring out Tommy's defense. The crowd behind MaClean here.
Shouting Ali. A sizable crowd here in the Odyssey Arena in Belfast, Ireland, shouting McLean's name.
Supporting their local boy, Jay.
Big time.
You know, that body's open too. McLean should switch to the body. You know, you kick that body enough, the head will die, you know.
Cut off the head of the snake, as they say in WikiLeaks, as the Saudis say. Sorry. McLean. Minute to go here in the second round.
McLean's still very cagey, but he's taking a bit more shots now, but a very cagey fight nonetheless. You know, McLean needs to get a bit more distance in those shots, Jay. If you can maybe cross-face him, push him straight back, land some more body shots.
Be interesting to see how the judges score the second round. Because it was about at the 2.5 minute mark that McLean reversed his fortunes in the round.
It's a tough one. Maguire looking a little bit gassed now. Looks like he's getting tired now. McLean looks like there's a lot of energy in the tank. So if I was McLean right now, I'd really go for the kill, you know.
Now is the time with 10 seconds to go in the second. Oh, it's going to be a tough round to score.
After two rounds of action, a unanimous judges' decision, the winner of the first semi-final, Insane Ali MaClean!
So Insane Ali MaClean moving on to the finals. He will face the winner of Bobby McVittie and Nomaan Khalid.
He just caught me with a shot right in the first exchange, which just rung me bell a bit. No, I thought it was a pretty poor performance on my behalf, because I know I can beat any lightweight in this tournament or anyone in the country, to be a fact. You know, I felt it was my tournament to take. I had the best record and I fought the best people, but I just didn't get to show it in there.
Khalid, last words as you head into the cage.
Introducing first, in the blue corner, fighting out of Team Ronin MMA, standing 5'8" tall and weighing in at 69.3 kilos, from Slough, Nomaan Khalid. And his opponent in the red corner, fighting out of Team Viper, standing 5'10" tall and weighing in at 69.5 kilos, from Port Glasgow, Bobby McVittie.
Time for a lightweight matchup. Guys, this is a good fight.
Yeah, I can feel it. I can feel the energy.
Quality matchup. These are guys who everybody has their eyes on.
Packing a lot of muscle there.
And leg kick. Oh, head kick just missing.
Khalid is pretty explosive. Could be a little bit of a strategic match over here, Jay. Looks very aggressive, so. Oh, lands two beautiful shots there, Khalid, on McVittie. Very crisp striker.
Khalid, a kickboxer on his feet, as you see McVittie get. Yeah, he got rolled, and now you see Khalid in the dominant position.
He did a nice reversal, Khalid. He got taken down, but he reversed the position there. Going for that half guard right there, throwing some punches, Khalid, on McVittie.
McVittie trying to keep him in tight, keep him honest. Winging right there from Khalid. Khalid is unimpeded in his punches now. McVittie going for the triangle.
He's going for a very tight triangle, Jay. I think he might get this. It looks very tight. He can also transition to the armbar. I think he got it.
A tap out at 1:08. Looks like Khalid's arm is hurt. His left arm, he had to tap at 1:08. That's exactly what you want to do in a tournament. You want to finish it short and sweet. He took no damage. He's not hurt. He feels fresh. In just a little over a minute, Bobby the Black Mamba McVittie will be going on to the finals. And here's that beautiful kick to the chest of Khalid, and then the takedown, and then the roll.
Nice reversal by Khalid.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the second semi-final in the first round with a triangle, Bobby McVittie!
McVittie is very fresh, Jay. This is only good news for him. You know, he can go back, rest up a little bit, end of the evening, come back and face McLean now. It's gonna be a good fight. I'm really feeling McLean versus McVittie. Fireworks.
So I gotta give, at least so far, Bobby, I gotta give submission of the night to McVittie.
Expected that to go longer.
Tell us what happened, Khalid.
I knew he was good on the floor, but I didn't know he's that good. But what can you do? I mean, should have stood up, kept going on the feet. Simple error, should have just stood back up, told him stand up, carried on trading, but didn't happen. He was too quick, caught me in the triangle first. Thought he was going for triangle. Tried to posture up and he got the armbar.
what can I do? Yeah, it's disappointing, but it's just what you do. I mean, it's just a sport, you know? And you've got a 50-50 chance of winning or losing, which is good enough for me, but unfortunately, it didn't go my way. More fights come, there'll always be fights. You gotta be positive, otherwise you break yourself down so much. I mean, you gotta take some criticism in and work on that. I mean, there's some bad points I may have made, some mistakes which I don't see, because you're in the adrenaline, going through the fight, you're not seeing the mistakes you're making. So hopefully, my friend here, Aaron, give me some feedback, and we could, you know, just work on it. Get back in the cage, hopefully come on top, you know.
Great spirit, thank you. Did you expect it to be such a quick win?
Yeah, I went out for the quick one. With it being a tournament format, then looked for it to be finished as quick as possible. Stay nice and fresh for the final.
So talk us through actually what happened.
Just came out, sussed each other out a little bit. Threw a few hands, a couple of silly back kicks, but then I just came in, took him down, judo experience, and then sort of pulled guard as such. Hit bump in triangle, so... Yeah.
He said that he knew that you were good on the floor, but he didn't know you were that good.
Well, that's quite common practice. They all know I'm quite good on the floor, but I've seen lots of videos. So.
Now, Bobby, it's not a normal situation. Like you say, you did that slightly tactical because you've got another fight. What's going through your head now that you've got to prepare yourself for that?
Just looking to chill out, get on top of things. Obviously speak to my team and see what plans are for the next one. But I'll be looking to do something similar and get it finished and get out.
Now, you didn't watch Ali fighting because Ali was actually ringside there watching you.
That doesn't bother me at all. He's probably watched plenty of videos of me anyway. It's all down to when we're in there and having a fight, so we'll just see if he underestimates me or not.
So game plan for this one?
Just go in and fight to the end and come out on top.
Thank you.
Cheers.
The following contest is the final fight in the tournament to crown the first ever CWC Lightweight Champion.
I'm going in there to prove a point.
Doesn't make a difference to me who I get. They're all going to lose, like.
All right, this is it. This is for the belt, the first ever belt given away by CWC. It is between these two lightweights right here, Bobby McVittie in the blue trunks, Ali Insane McClean, and there's the stare down for the belt. These two want this belt desperately. This is what makes your career as a fighter, wrapping that heavy piece of gold, that heavy strap around your waist. Here we go, this one. Scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds for the title. And they are trading.
You hit the nail on the head there, Jay. Both of these guys want it bad. They're both coming out strong. I think Ali went in there pretty hard, landing a nice combo. But Ali's may have had a longer fight the last round. And so I think the fresher guy is McVittie. So both guys need to pace themselves very carefully.
McVittie had a 1-minute and 8-second triangle win over Nomaan Khalid, so he has to be the fresher of the two. Ali MaClean had a grinder with Tom Maguire, but he did have a lot of time to go back and recompose.
Some nice counters by McVittie, but Ali is very, very aggressive. You can see the fire in his eye, Jay. He wants it. And, good counter right low kick by McClean right there. A little bit bloody in his face, looks like a scratch on his cheek. I don't think it's anything serious, though.
I think it was the first exchange. We saw him go back and sort of lick his wounds after that first exchange.
McClean landing a pretty nice clubbing, right-hand counter to McVittie, who kind of steamed in front of him. Both guys don't want to make a mistake right now.
Bobby McVittie fighting out of Glasgow, Scotland, Team Viper, 7-7 as a pro. Ali MaClean, as you heard, the local favorite fighting right out of right here, Belfast. We are in the famed Odyssey Arena, home of the Belfast Giants.
McLean's got a lot of gas in that tank. He's pretty wound up and he's still going. Landing some good knees to McVittie's face. McVittie's got to be careful with the clinch. And he's a bit more experienced there. Big energy dump by both these fighters. Looping right hand grazes Ali's face over there.
Both of these combatants have had a long time to think about it. They've been back in the locker room. We've had 16 fights tonight. They've had a lot of time to think about that belt and what it would mean to their career.
Yo, you're right, Jay. A belt like that, a four-man tournament, can literally make your career. McVittie kind of rushed in a little bit there. Wasn't really paying attention. McVittie rushed in and he paid the price there. McLean took him down.
Good position for Insane McLean. He's got McVittie punched up against the cage, close to his corner.
And that rib is open. McVittie needs to work that rib, work that body, work the face. You know, who knows when this opportunity will come again. So, you know, it's time for, if Ali really wants it, he's got to really push for it.
It looked like McVittie had an opportunity to walk the cage. He opted not to, and instead is composing the open guard. Closes up now.
You know, may be worried about getting countered and being taken by side or getting hit in that position, which is the danger sometimes of walking a cage.
Oh, nice left hammer fist there from Insane. McVittie's got to get out of there. This is a horrible position for him.
Yeah, Ali's accelerating a little bit now and he's landing some good shots. Yo, the referee's looking very carefully right now.
And right now, McLean's corner is calling for Insane to stack McVittie.
Now we've seen another rubber guard move, and McLean switches from rubber to the armbar, but the capsule was too close to McLean's body. He needs that capsule past the groin area to really accelerate and get that move there.
This was really who's going to be the first guy to go to his back. Both, like you said, both fighters were nervous. They were cautious. They both had a big energy dump at the beginning of the fight, and an ill-advised rush in from McVittie put him in this bad position.
Yeah, you know, you got to pick your shots a bit more carefully. In a haste, he rushed into McLean and he paid the price for it. You know, Ali could be a bit more busier for this position too. You know, that body is clearly open. I would, you know, Ali should start working that body around now. Easier said than done though, right, Jay?
30 seconds to go in the opener. This is for the belt. For the Cage Wars champion, lightweight championship belt.
You know, you can sense McVittie's, you know, going for some form of submission. He's thinking of the move. He's thinking of a setup. The leg is on the hip. The foot is on the hip. He's trying to position his hips. He's thinking for some movement here. But, you know, Ali's got him stacked really hard against the cage, and he's hammer fisting him and stopping that hip movement there.
Good first round as it comes to a close for the Insane McLean. Just what he needed. Picked up a nasty welt, which he's checking in the big screen here. One of the best big screens I've seen ever. We got half of the wall is a video screen here in Belfast.
That was interesting. He just checked his face to see what the damage of the cup was.
He sure did.
Very alert. There's no quit. There's no quitting Ali McLean, though. There's absolutely no quitting this young boy.
Picked up a nice weld there under the right eye on the right cheekbone as we get ready for our second round here in the Odyssey Arena. Belfast, Ireland. Jay Adams alongside Bobby Razek. Glad you joined us. Nice overhand right there. And I tell you, McVittie's rushing in without setting it up.
Yeah, he's rushing in, he's getting countered. He got caught overhand right. He's trying to do a judo hip throw there. McLean countered.
He's got no answer. He's starting to look frustrated, Bobby.
At the same time, he's got to try new things. But at the same time, you've got to pick your shots. McLean comes over with a clean attack left, right. Puts McVittie against the back. It's looking a little dangerous for Bobby McVittie here.
I think McVittie could be hurt. There's something that has disheartened him.
Yeah, he's frustrated, disheartened. Came back with a nice uppercut there, though.
Yeah, that was a nice uppercut. He's still in it.
Yeah, you
he's
never
just
know.
Mentally trying to figure out what he needs to do.
Oh, I think he stunned him there. He stunned him. He's going to take him out. I think the referee's going to be stepping in any moment.
Going for the armbar.
Great heart by McVittie.
McVittie's tricky.
He's taking a lot of punishment now, though. You know the beauty of MMA, Jay? You never know until the final bell, until the final count, the final submission. We thought McVittie was going to get taken out there, but he surprised him with an armbar attempt, you know? The beauty of mixed martial arts, guys.
Bobby McVittie holding on for dear life. All he really seems to have at this stage of the game is a surprise submission, if he can pull a rabbit out of his head. He is not winning the stand-up match with McLean.
Going for another armbar attempt. He didn't have the capsule in, though. He could have pulled an arm in tighter, and he played a piper for doing it incorrectly.
McLean effortlessly moves to side control on the Black Mamba, Bobby McVittie.
He's underhooking that elbow. He's going for a choke.
Taps him out at 2 minutes and 10 seconds of the second round. Ali Insane McLean wins the CWC lightweight belt. And how happy is this young man? And Patty says, get back in the cage, young man, and you'll get your due.
You know, Ali threw his gum shield on McVittie on the ground. A little bit of immaturity there by McLean, but he's still 20 years old. He's a young fighter in his growth.
Ali Insane McLean putting the belt around his waist.
I got you.
And now he says to Bobby Razzik, are you going to hook me up? Are you going to hook me up? He wants to know. As he comes over to the broadcast dais to say hello to us and say, are you going to hook me up? As he's going to put a very heavy piece of gold strap around his waist. Ali Insane McLean. All right, I'm going to go up and talk with the new champ.
2 minutes and 8 seconds into the second round, the winner of the fight and first ever CWC lightweight champion, Ali Insane McLean.
Bobby, how hard was that?
Yeah, it was a tough fight. Even before the first fight, I pulled something in my stomach, so I gassed in there pretty quick. But that happens. So.
Did you expect it to be as aggressive as that? Because he didn't let up.
Yeah, I knew it was going to be aggressive. I knew it was going to be a high-paced fight. So.
So it's mixed emotions because you won one and then had to come out and face a crowd that was really behind Ali as well.
Yeah. The crowd doesn't really faze me anyway, but it would have been nice to get the win, but hopefully next time.
Okay, well done.
I'm here with the champ. How good does it hear? How good does it sound to hear that word? I'm here with the champ. Does that sound good?
Sounds pretty damn good to me. All them months of hard work, dedication, 5 years of living in the gym, it finally paid off tonight. Thank you to Belfast crowd. Thank you to Paddy Mooney. Thank you to Johnny Burroughs. Thank you to Tom Smith, Chris Kelly, all the rest of the people at Keys Wars for raising me basically from the amateurs all the way to the pro. They've basically made my life in a way.
I mean, yeah, okay. You really did do her proud. Now let's talk about this belt. What does this mean for you now, Ali?
It's from 9 years old, from 15 years old doing, or from 9 years old doing judo, from 15 years old doing MMA, wrestling, about 10 years of hard work and living in the gym for the last 3 years.
So you're wearing it proudly. Now, the whole crowd was behind you, particularly your girlfriend. She is so vocal. What did it mean to be doing it in front of your neighbours?
I couldn't have asked for a better crowd. I really couldn't have. They couldn't have screamed any louder. They couldn't have done any better. Not at all.
Ali, wear the first ever Cage Wars Championship lightweight
history.
Title belt.
History. History.
Well done.
The winner of the fight and first ever CWC lightweight champion.